We're starting to move into the teeth of non-dual consideration. Starting to move into the teeth of it, which is great, which is great. To get this far is really, really great. Now, let us say we want to bring an end to the path. Let's say, I really want to bring an end to the path. We think, oh, that's great. I really have this desire to bring an end to the path. That's great. Okay, now. We will look at this and say, when we desire to bring an end, do we not immediately give rise to a belief system that includes a beginning? And if we have a beginning, doesn't that imply an end? Or if it doesn't imply an end, does it not imply at least some sort of progress or process? What it implies really is determinacy, meaning a beginning to something, beginning to something. It can't just be completely abstract, beginning to something. It really means determinism, belief in determinism. So when we say, I want to bring it to an end, we are literally stating a belief in determinism. Okay, now, determinism means that one moment is joined to another moment. One moment is the cause, in part, at least, of another moment. That what each moment is dependent on previous moments. And the future is dependent on moments that are happening now, which are dependent on the past moments. So it's like a chain of causation. This is called determinacy. That what we're doing is determining the future. Okay. Now, what we're told by the great teachers, for example, Jesus, that reality is indeterminate. Indeterminate. Each moment is perfectly free and clear of all other moments. No moment shapes or molds any other moment whatsoever. So when we say, I want to bring an end to this, we are literally reinforcing the false belief in determinacy. Okay, now, to get a feel of where you're at is to say, well, okay, then let nothing end. Say, let nothing come to an end. Let there be no end whatsoever. Okay, how do you feel about that? Let there be no end whatsoever. Now, what we're saying then is, let there be no beginning also. If there's no such thing as an end whatsoever, how can we really talk about a beginning? A beginning to what? So, let there be no end whatsoever, is a statement of indeterminacy. Because no end, no beginning, no middle, no determinacy. So in phase four, we have this turnaround where before we're thinking like, we want to get free. We want to finish the path. We want to end the path. We must end this path, bring this path to an end. It doesn't seem to come to an end. Because why? Why can't we not? The truth is we can bring nothing to an end. An end is impossible. Because a beginning is impossible. And there is no in-between. Endings are impossible. Now, to hear that endings are impossible depends where you're at on these phases, 1, 2, 3, or 4. this fourth phase, we just do a full stop in this. And just absorb it. Hear it, absorb it. There are no endings. Nothing can be brought to an end. Why? Because there aren't any things. No path can be brought to an end because no path ever began. You can't begin a path. If each moment is completely free and clear of every other moment, how can you say that you began something? What beginning means is a beginning of influencing the next moment. And there is no such condition in reality. So if there aren't any beginnings, how can there be any endings? Now, this type of talk used to be looked at as gobbledygook, just complete nonsense, gibberish. But now we're seeing it and saying, wow, this is entirely profound. So if I give up all desire for endings, I stand in my natural state. I realize and recognize my natural condition. Or not my natural condition, but I recognize original nature. Or not just original nature, but I recognize true nature. The one and only. The one and onlyness. The one and only oneness. So when we wonder, why have those who have gone before us have managed to relax and accept the one and only oneness? What have they gone through? Well, now we know. Is at some point they have to look at it differently, flip the script and say, hey, wait a minute. There aren't any endings. And the more we accept that there aren't any endings, the more we dissolve the notion of any beginnings. And if there are no beginnings, how can we be trapped and even need any endings at all? How can we be trapped at all? So it starts with the saying, giving up the notion of any endings whatsoever. You say, well, how long does delusion last? As long as we're searching for an ending, that's how long delusion lasts. So this is a dramatic turnaround. As long as we are searching for an ending, that's how long delusion lasts. I had a rough day today. It was very clumsy. Nothing. Everything was awkward. Everything was awkward starting on. I mentioned it to people. I said, you know, I'm not having a good day. This day is not, is out of sync. Everything's out of sync. I said, wow, I need to flip this script. This is really something. It's dangerous. I don't understand the clumsiness and just bumping into stuff and dropping stuff and just everything's out of sync. Well, wouldn't you know it, Dada? A steel beam slipped off a forklift and it almost hit me. It was a near miss. It happened so fast, you know. That was, you know, I said, wow. So, rough day today, for sure. Grace of God that the, you know, beam didn't hit me. Grace of God that there are things that happen so quickly you don't even see it coming. sometimes you have those days and you feel that this just, wow, I feel out of it. This is not good. Missed a turnoff driving home. I never missed that. I can't believe I missed that. What in the world is wrong? What is going on? Other people experience troubles. Do they do, actually? There's something going on today that is throwing everything out of sync in the world. That is for sure. But we have this non-dual consideration. It may seem totally idiotic to most people. They're missing the missing out, though. So the way of freedom is to not to seek an ending, but to give up seeking for any ending. And so you simultaneously then give up all beginnings. And when you've given up all beginnings, what are you left with? Freedom. True nature. Our true nature. Now, on the surface of things, I'm just a bumbling, stumbling fool of no consequence whatsoever, of no importance whatsoever in the world. That's what it feels like, too. But, and then the flip side, I'm able to look at this, you know, clearly, directly, with a full stop in the now of it. That's the flip side. So it's... People think that when they come to an end, like they die, that frees them. How can coming to an end free us of determinacy when it automatically then is pointing out a beginning? Beginning and ending is a duality which obscures freedom. So we think, no, we must bring all this to an end. We must bring all this to an end. No, what we must do is realize nothing ever started. That's quite different than bringing something to an end. There are no beginnings. So certainly if there are no beginnings, how can we bring anything to an end? But in recognizing that there are no beginnings, we stop trying to bring something to an end. How can we have an end unless we're bringing something to an end? Keep this in mind. What are we bringing to an end? The complex of belief systems, we must believe we're bringing something to an end, but when we see there's never been any beginnings at all, we don't need to bring anything to an end. We don't need a complex. We don't need a belief system. We don't need something that needs to be brought to an end. Sickness, old age, death, we don't need any of that. We're completely free this instant of everything. Each instant is completely free of everything. If there's no beginning, how can one be bound by anything? So there's total freedom. Every moment is total freedom. not bound by any beginnings. So whatever's arising is not binding at all. Now, the thing to do is don't make anything of this. Just hear it. Get used to it. Getting used to it is the key. Just getting used to hearing this and looking at your reactions, just not following any storyline of reactions, just keep getting used to it and see how you feel about it. Don't draw any conclusions. You see, to bring something to an end, doesn't there have to be that something? If you want to bring something to an end, let's say I want to bring mental illness to an end. Well, doesn't that mean the mental illness has to be there? If you say, I have no desire to bring mental illness to an end whatsoever. In fact, endings are impossible. Then you certainly don't need it there as proof of anything being brought to an end. So the causation, so to speak, is emptied out that way. I don't need to bring anything to an end. So the causation of all those anythings is no longer present. If you say, I want to bring injustice to an end, well, then we need injustice in order to bring it to an end, right? It means that injustice had a beginning, which means we're not free, which means we're determinate. Reality is determined, that's the belief, right? Had a beginning. One free moment, totally free, cannot be said to be a beginning of anything. It's not a beginning of anything. If all is perfectly free as far as experiencing, choosing, experiencing, how can it be said that there's a beginning of something? There isn't. There's no beginning at all. So how could there be a beginning of injustice? There couldn't be. It's only our desire to bring it to an end that cleverly suggests a beginning. And once begun, how do you... Once the belief in determinism is there, then it can simply, what is stopping the belief at that point to imagine all infinite manner of processes and determinism? Accept determinism at all, and you can extrapolate, in infinite scenarios of determinism. And the belief in bringing those to an end. So we're hanging out in the kitchen here. I don't know what a teacher would say. It wouldn't be anything like how to bring it to something to an end. Just then you have to say, oh, wait a minute, that doesn't sound right. Which is why I believe the Hatha Yoga of like Longchenpa, what that's getting at is this whole situation. All the lesser teachings are working to bring something to an end. Really, that's reinforcing delusion. But the momentum of discipline in moving your comfort zone, getting used to that, enables one then to move it into the fourth phase, where you've been able to turn it around, flip the whole script, and say, hey, wait a minute. You know, that's what was keeping me deluded. The efforts to end delusion is the delusion. The effort to end delusion is the delusion. Now, of course, the trouble is we may get indignant about this because we say, wait a minute, I've worked so hard on the spiritual path to come bring it to an end, and now you're saying there isn't the effort to bring it to an end is the imprisonment. The effort to end delusion is the delusion, and I've been working all this time to end delusion. Well, so the question is, do you get indignant or not? If you don't, then you're really very well into the fourth phase, where you really cannot afford those kind of reactions anymore. You just stay quiet. Do not form an opinion or a judgment or conclusion or anything like that. We just look at the reasoning. Just notice the reasoning behind this. You know, determinism, indeterminism, endings, beginnings, and we look at looking at this. We just say, yeah, I see that. Try to just be neutral at first. Just okay, see that. Draw any conclusions, don't take sides, don't do anything, just say, okay, I see that. I'm seeing that. Extrapolate of what's going to be the outcome of this. I don't know. But I'm getting familiar with it. It certainly can't hurt. That's the way I look at it. Like, sure, this sure isn't hurting anything. That's for, you know, this has got to be helping. I don't know what the outcome will be or anything, but it certainly, this is not hurting. This is helping. Being able to turn the belief system around like this. It's difficult. This is the turnaround. Turnaround is difficult. You make this turnaround. Yeah. The desire to end delusion is delusion. The desire to end anything is the beginning. That is the beginning. And the middle is the entirety of it. Desire to end it. So we're gently leading the mind back towards, you know, right perspective here and seeing this. I'm getting used to this. But you could go in this world for a long, long time and not ever come across, you know, such a formulation and a viewpoint. It only comes from, you know, those who have recognized what freedom is, and accepted what, you know, freedom as it is, and that they help others, share with others, and so we're just trying to nibble away at this here. Some teachers liken it to a rat nibbling at a rope, and Just a little bit at a time, a little bit at a time, just not gnawing away at this rope. And one day, they gnaw just a little and tie a little bit more, and poof, you know, that's it, the rope breaks. So we don't know. We don't know when the turnaround will happen. We just keep gnawing away a little bit, nibbling away. Just nibble, 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 nibble. That's all. Because we realize that this is a very potentially, you know, alarming. Well, you have to go careful, slow and careful. It's very alarming. And easily panic. We're not, because this is the fourth phase, but one could see that panicking is possible. But I don't want to even think about it. Yeah, it's too dangerous to even think about it. Because we say, oh, I'm so miserable. What do you mean there's no end? How could it be end? I want an end of this misery. It's the desire to end misery that is the misery. It's not separate. Desire to end misery is the misery. It's all one. That is all one. It's not two things. It's one. Because how can we end misery? Desire to end misery means there must be misery. We must insist upon misery in order to end it. So the mind is like waking up right now. This is waking the mind up. So we just sit, you know, ho-hum. This is the benefit of practice, that even in this situation, we can just sit here with relative calm. Oh, we're waking up. Okay, well, let's keep sitting here. Whether I wake up or don't wake up, I'm still just going to sit here quietly. So, see, that much is stable. So we have this ground of familiar, continuous stability. And within that, we're able to then entertain the waking up of the mind. But this is the right way to use the body, to use existence, is to let the body be the stable ground of continuity, of experiencing. And just have it sit quietly and say, oh, okay, I'm very comfortable, familiar with this. And then let the realization be the shift, the turnaround, but with a sense of continuity. That's the right use of body, right use of time, right use of body, right use of time, right use of mind. If we say, oh, I want to bring an end to dying, well, there has to be a dying then. So we have to start working on, I have no desire for any endings. No desire for any endings whatsoever. just continue this kind of laid back, patient, full stopness. This is the key to very rapid progress, which we are making right now, very rapid progress. And we need to, right? We got those who, this world is trying to really shuffle a lot of stuff around. I've had it with this Bay Area. The drivers here are just nuts. I don't like their attitude. Yeah, I just had enough of it. Really had enough of it. This is just not me. This is not the way. I don't like to feel this way. Where you're almost forced into aggression, and every day I have to tell myself, you know, don't get angry, don't look at the driver, just keep your cool. Good Lord, the people are, if they, you know, they're just so aggressive that they just go for it, and you have to then react, like say, whoa, you know, we've got to pull back, prevent some accident. Because everybody here thinks they're seeing openings, you know, they think that this is the attitude. Oh, I can do this. Oh, I can do this. I can think I see. And there's accidents all over the place. So if you don't want to get an accident, you've got to say, whoa, back off of this. You know, who wants to live in that kind of a shark tank? It's a shark tank here. It really is. There's all these sharks, you know, looking for openings. Well-mannered sharks, prosperous sharks, you know. But that doesn't make it any better. It's just like, hey, it's frantic here. It is absolutely frantic. And I say, I've had enough of this. This is not me. I don't want to live like this. I don't want to get out on the road. I don't want to feel that way. I want to feel expansive, relaxed, and expansive, and happy. And when people drive to a store that way, they're happy in the store. Everyone's relaxed. They're chatting. But when they drive the way this in the Silicon Valley here in the Bay Area, you get to a store, they're all nervous, they're all uptight. You pick that up from them, you say, wow, there's no friendliness here. The aggressiveness is there, the defensiveness is there and everything. What kind of quality of life is that? Everybody claims there's some quality of life here. I don't feel it. It's the weather, you know, it's the weather and the scenery and stuff, but quality of life, no way. So, I think the key to shifting is don't bring anything to an end. Somehow, we have to work on this. Some way to get out. If you're in a situation you don't like, there's some way to get out of it. I've been trapped in here for my whole life. Never liked it here, actually. But I haven't been able to get out. So the key is to realize that I was never trapped here. Okay? Something like that. Key to getting free of a body is realizing you're never in a body. How can freedom be in something? How can freedom be trapped somewhere? Again, flipping the script. So, we're just continuing to get familiar, more familiar with this. There's a term. The path, the mind becomes the path or something. There's some way of like what we're doing, you know, the familiarity, the continuity, it tends to keep the momentum going like this. So nothing, we don't have to, all we have to do is continue to consider these, make these considerations with the full stop in the now of it, full stop in the wow. Again, the turnaround, there's nothing to turn around. So give up all turnarounds. Give up all turnarounds, give up all shifts, give up all endings. Continue to see how this develops as we get into the real teeth of this. I don't know, this is just, you know, we're just traveling through this and just getting comfortable. So we're comfortable here, say, okay, I'm comfortable with this, and then see where that comfort takes us. Struggling too much, so just the natural momentum, we're just floating down the river. Okay. Again, try not to think about it. Be aware that this is quite a shock to the whole notion of belief systems, isn't it? It's a shock to the very notion of any belief system. You might say, the final belief system is to say, I don't need a belief system. Belief system of, I don't need a belief system. I believe I don't need a belief system. Okay, and that's maybe the final one. All right. So, we shall see. Very great. That's it.